Hello, this is Angela Anderson. Thanks for joining me tonight. We are going to be painting very simple sunset with a giraffe in silhouette. Should be fun. It's kind of a giraffe mania going on YouTube right now, so I thought we'd get in on the fun. Got my husband Mark here.
Hey there, everybody.
And we are going to be trying to do this in about an hour tonight. I'll show you step by step all the way through. How to create your own giraffe painting. Mark's got his sound on his computer there, so. Bad Mark.
And I thought I checked all the boxes.
Nope.
Obviously not.
Missed one. It's all right. We forgive you. Okay, so I've got a canvas panel. I'm going to go ahead and do it on the 9x12, 9-inch by 12-inch canvas panel here. It's actually a gesso board. It's more like a masonite board thing. Got these in a multi-pack recently, and they've been working out pretty good. So I like them because they're the same size as my practice sheets here. So I'm going to set that aside, and I'll click on the image up in the corner for you so you can see it while I'm painting. I've got just a few colors. And of course, as with all of my silhouette paintings, this one can be adapted to whatever theme you want. So you don't have to put a giraffe in yours. You can just do the tree, or you can do whatever. I've got several different silhouette ones that I've done so far, and you can mix and match. That's the nice thing about them. So my color palette is titanium white, cadmium yellow light, cadmium orange, cadmium red medium, cadmium red light, quinacridone magenta, and dioxazine purple. And this is just some extra white over here for mixing. I'll try to keep that in view. Don't know. We'll see. So I'm going to start with the light colors first and then work to the darker. And we're going to go all the way to the bottom of the canvas here. There'll just be a little bit of grass at the very bottom that kind of creates our foreground. So I'm going to just create an area where I want the brightest part of the sun to be showing through the clouds. And my tree is going to be like in this general direction, and then we're going to have the giraffe over here. So I want my white area to be kind of right up in here, so it'll be peeking through above the tree. So I'm going to put that in first and sort of create my area for my, I've got a half inch filbert here. It's about a half inch, I think. I don't know. Might be a little bit bigger than that, but so I'm just going to use it to create my cloud shapes, and it's going to kind of zigzag from this main area here. So this is going to be our main bright area, and then it'll kind of radiate out this way a little bit, start to fade out into pinks. There'll be purple at the top, and then it'll get kind of orangey and red down towards the bottom here. So I'm going to put a little bit of this white in here. And now I'm going to start to pick up some of my cadmium yellow light, and I'm going to mix that in with that white. And we'll start putting that in around the white areas, just a little bit, mostly below, but there's a little bit that kind of hits at the top around it. And this area is very yellow all through here. Working the light to dark will just kind of help our light stay nice and bright. It's easy for these dark colors to kind of overwhelm the brighter ones once we get them on our brush and in our water. Okay, it's looking pretty good. I'm going to get a little bit more of that yellow out this way. This cadmium yellow light is so bright. It's very, like, it's almost like neon yellow. Day glow. Grab some more of it. And we'll put some in down here, really low.
So what yellow is that?
Cadmium yellow light.
Cad yellow light.
Mm-hmm. You could use cadmium yellow medium. It's just a little bit more on the orange side. This one's a little bit brighter. So, or a lot brighter.
Yeah, I was just going to say that.
You were thinking that?
Yeah, I just was wondering why you didn't go with the cad yellow medium.
You were thinking that, were you?
Yeah, so that's why I just had to ask what.
Excuse me, don't make me laugh.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, goodness. Yep, very. Okay, so adding a little bit more of the bright, bright, bright yellow up and through here, too. It's looking pretty good. So now we'll grab our orange. We're just going to work our way around the palette, adding brighter and brighter colors, or darker and darker, I guess. Add a little bit of white to this just to tone it down a little bit. Maybe a little bit of that yellow to start with. And now we're going to start to be a lot more selective where we want to put this. So let's go ahead and put a little bit of it through here. There's going to be kind of a cloud formation that kind of comes down here. And I'm just using the filbert like on its edge to get some of these thinner lines and then turning it flat to do some of the longer, wider spots. Put a little bit up around here. Lighten it up a little bit so that it's lighter around our sun. And there's a whole set of clouds that kind of comes off here. Bring it all the way to the edge there. We can put some of the pinks over the top. And I'm going to grab a little bit of, put out a little bit of my blending medium now. This is glazing, acrylic glazing liquid, golden. And it'll give me a little bit extra blend time for these clouds. If you are going over an area and you find that your paint is starting to get sticky, just let it dry completely. Take a hairdryer to it or work on another area until it starts to dry. You don't want to mess with your acrylics while they're drying because it will start to lift and cause problems for you. So definitely don't want that to happen. Okay, just lightly brushing with this orangey color, kind of creating a little cloud burst here and there. And then most of this area up here is going to be all pinks and purples all at the top there. So my mic making noises? I can tell you're making little triangle tape triangles over there.
Don't give away any secrets.
Sorry.
Behind the scenes. I was trying to be very, very quiet.
You're crinkling the tape over there.
Nobody knew what was going on.
Well, until I said something.
Well,
sorry.
I know you ratted me out.
Okay, let's bring some of this orange down here. Do it nice and low. Most of this is going to be covered up by grass, so actually might want to bring this yellow up a little bit because it's going to be disappear in the grasses. And this area over here is going to be pink and purple, so I don't want it too much of that orange or yellow over there. Okay, a little bit more of that bright orange down there. All the way across. It's like... Pretty soon I'm not going to be able to move at all. All this tape taping me down everywhere. I wondered when I wore this shirt. It's a little bit loose, so I thought it might cause you problems with the audio.
Well, if you would just not move.
If I would just not move,
yeah,
there would be no problem.
It would be perfectly fine.
Okay.
I wouldn't have to tape you down as much.
Sorry. Okay, so I'm going to put a little layer of that brighter orange at the top. Okay, now I'm going to grab some of the next color, which is our cadmium red light. And we'll start adding a little bit of that in. Tap in gently around the edge there to kind of create a fuzzy line that goes across. Down here and blends out with this. You notice I'm not using a whole lot of paint on my brush so that it allows me to blend. If I have a lot of paint on my brush, it won't blend as easily. It'll just kind of push the paint around. It won't necessarily blend with the other colors that I'm working with. So I'm keeping my brush fairly lightly loaded with paint helps. And we're kind of coming up to that layer, kind of meaning these two sections here. Pick up a little bit more of this color. Add a little bit more of that. Grab a little bit of that glazing medium there. Mix in with it. This brush is quite stiff too, so it also will help the blending process. It's a Simmons titanium, so it's got a lot of stiffness to it. Allows me to really get in there and blend. Alright, that's looking pretty good. Let's put a little bit of this color down below here. Okay, this is starting to get sticky now, so I'm going to avoid that. And I'm going to clean out my brush because I'm getting into my pinks now and purples. We'll work the pinks around and then add a little bit of the purple to it. You don't want to mix your purple with your yellow because they're opposite on the color wheel, so it makes a good contrast, but they will turn into a muddy color if you mix them together. So that's why you want to be sure that you clean out your brush really well before you grab your purples. This one is quinacridone magenta with some white now. Here, turn it. And we'll add it around here on this side. Let me add a lot more white to it, make a light pink version. How you doing, hon?
I'm doing good.
Sound better?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Now that you're not moving. No.
not wanting to blend right there, so I'm going to let that set, and I'll come back to it with a little bit of this orange and blend it back in. But for right now, I'm just going to keep on moving up around here, and then I'll soften these blends areas later.
So you may have said it at the beginning while I wasn't paying attention. Is this a beginner level painting?
I think so. Medium? Yeah, I mean, it's got some blending in it, so, you know, that part would be maybe a little bit tricky, but I don't think it's super difficult. I think if you kind of followed along the way I'm doing it, it's good. You know, I think that if you, you know, do it the way I'm doing it here, it should be easy enough to follow.
So they need to be taped down with a microphone too?
I don't know. I mean, it could help. There's no
telling. You never know, yeah. So for the new people that are just finding your channel, this is kind of more of a medium, entry to medium level?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, I'd say. Definitely. What?
You're not following my questions, and I'm trying to get you to...
Entry to medium level? What? Well, welcome. So just if what?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead. Yes. She got it.
So if you're new to my channel, is this what you're wanting me to say, obviously?
Wow, you thought of that all yourself.
Sorry. I'm a little slow tonight. Welcome, and we do these shows twice a week right now, at least in 2017. There's no telling what we'll be doing next year, but we're glad to have you watching with us tonight. And after the show, if you want to subscribe, that'd be awesome. Well, if you will subscribe now, you can chat with us during the show and ask questions if you catch it live. And after the show, you can go click on my name or my picture, and it'll take you to my channel, and you can see all the other videos that I have for beginners and intermediates, depending on your experience level. I've got all kinds of different tutorials. Usually Tuesday night tutorials are my easier ones, and then Saturdays are my more advanced ones, or longer ones at least. So, grabbing some purple now, mixing that in with my light pink color there, so to make it a little bit softer, and I'm going to add that in. This is going to look really weird, right? Looks really odd right now. That is normal. So don't panic when you get in the middle of a painting and it looks weird. I have a lot of people that post things to me that, you know, they say, oh, I couldn't do it, and they post something, and it's like halfway finished, and I'm thinking, well, it's, you know, it's just not finished. Nothing looks good when it's in the middle of its, you know, finishing stages. So if you could just keep on working at it and follow the tutorials as best you can. If you notice, you know, mine doesn't look real good at this point either, so... That's normal. So don't panic when you're in the middle of a painting and it doesn't look like you think it's going to look, because it's going to be like your brain is going to fight you on it and tell you that it doesn't look right. But you're on the right track. We're going to get there. So just keep working at it, and I'll show you how to finish it. Okay. I'm going to get a little bit darker as I go up to the top. Go ahead.
Somebody's asked a question, so that they... accidentally bought a Liquitex yellow azo. But what they wanted to get was the cad yellow medium.
Okay.
So they want to know, is it that much different, and would you suggest to
buy the
cad
yellow? I don't have that color, so I'm not really sure how it compares. Okay. That's one of the ones that I don't have. I want to say that azo is a little bit more transparent, but it should say on the bottle what how, you know, if it's transparent or not. the cadmium yellow medium is not transparent. So if you were looking for a non-transparent yellow, that one, you may just have to add a little bit of white to it when you work with it to get it to cover in some areas. Okay, so I'm going to add a little bit of this purple coming down into this here. A little bit down in here. There's just a few little clouds that are kind of reaching down here. This is like just a little bit lighter version of what I did up here. So I added a little bit more white, made another, you can see the difference there in the colors. So I'm going to add a little bit more of this lighter purple up in here. We try not to take ourselves too seriously, but we do. I'm all about helping beginners have some success with their first paintings. That's kind of my goal, is to get you past that scary stage of picking up a brush for the first time and be able to have some tutorials that will guide you. And I have a lot of people that do their first paintings with me and do a really great job and get hooked right away. So I'll warn you, don't start unless you want to plan on painting for a while, because it is addicting for sure. Okay, so there we go. That's looking, whoa, what happened there?
Somebody's asked, why are you using a filbert brush and not a bright?
Just because it's got a little bit softer roundness on the edges, but you could use a bright instead. Just find that the filbert, when I'm doing these kind of rounded cloud shapes, it's sometimes it gives it a softer, fuzzier, more rounded edge for the clouds. So that's the only reason. But yeah, bright would work just as well.
I didn't know clouds were fuzzy.
Yeah, of course they are.
Interesting. My eyes breathe. Yeah. And clouds are fuzzy.
They are fuzzy.
I'm learning all kinds of things on this art channel.
All right, so I've got a clean water jar over here, and I'm cleaned out my brush, and then I'm dipping it into the clean water just to kind of keep it from contaminating my yellows. And so now I'm going to grab my yellows again, and I'm going to blend between these two here to get these edges kind of blended in and add some of the brighter clouds up in this area. So what I'm going to do is mix just a little bit of this cadmium red light with my quinacridone magenta. It'll make a red. And then I'm going to grab some white. Let me mix a little bit more of it. Wipe a little bit of the extra off just so it's not too much, and I'm going to use that up here along there, and then I'm going to start adding a little bit of it. It's going to be scary at first because it's going to be like, wow, that's bright. Keep your brush pushed flat so that you've got a good edge that you can work with, and just tap in some of these clouds. And they're kind of zigzagged, you notice. This will help blend and bring these two layers together now. Grab a little bit more white. And add a little bit more white. Make like a pink color. Then I can add over the top little bit up in here, that lighter color, that lighter pink. Tone it down. Help blend out the edges, just kind of going around what I put in there, and it'll help kind of set it back a little bit. See how that's working? Put a little bit of it up here. Don't want to touch into my yellow too much, so I'm just trying to kind of stay just above it. Along here. We'll use this to transition these two colors together right here. This is a good, just kind of light. Light pink. See, now it's starting to blend and make a little bit more sense. Grab a little blending medium. Glazing medium, I should say. Just going to take our time on the sunset, get it right, because the giraffes are going to go fast. All the giraffes are basically just an outline that you're filling in with black. So there's not a whole lot of, and I'm using a traceable, so it'll make it a lot easier for the beginners. I'll have the traceable available on my Patreon page there, $1 a month for all the traceables that I have on Patreon. So it includes 8 new ones every month and all of the older ones from my older tutorials from February on. So February this year, so last month basically, is when I started on Patreon. So it doesn't have my older ones. The older ones are on Thankful Art on Facebook, but the newer ones are all going on Patreon. So any of the newer tutorials will be on there. Okay, so that's looking good. I'm going to blend these two together here. And I still feel like there needs to be a little bit of yellow mixture. So I'm going to grab some yellow and see what that does with this. I think it should blend fine. Grab a little bit more white. Kind of make an in-between color for this transition here. We'll just blend that over that edge. So anytime you're meeting up two colors, you just want to get the values to be similar. So these dark areas, if I put them over the top, it'll have, you know, a really bold effect. If I want to blend it in, I want to find the color that's closest to the color that's in value. When I say value, I mean light and dark. So this color is obviously a lot darker than the yellow. So I'm going to find a yellow or a, that's why I did the light pink, to help blend those in, the transition between the pinks and the oranges. Pinks and the yellows, I mean. So by grabbing this light yellow, I'm blending out these pinks that are close to it in value into this brighter yellow to make it look like the transition's a little bit softer, a little bit easier to for your eye to comprehend. That makes sense. I don't know if that meant sense at all. Kind of. So basically, you just want to find a color that's similar to what you're trying to blend and use that. Okay, we're getting there. It's looking pretty good.
Okay, somebody asked, could you explain all that again?
Explain all that again.
Because okay. They're confused with the blending that
okay,
you're doing.
Okay, all right.
It's not me, for real.
No, it's all right. Yeah, I wasn't sure what I was trying to explain there myself.
Oh. I can't believe somebody was actually paying attention to you.
I know. They were actually listening.
Wow.
And not chatting.
That's weird. I don't know what that's all about. I'll try to correct that.
Okay. Give them something to chat about. Okay, so basically when I'm trying to blend this yellow with this pink, right? They're not going to blend really easily unless I have them both wet at the same time and they pick up a little bit of each other. But to replicate that, I can mix the two of them together. So that's what I did here with this yellow. I mixed it with this pink and then made sure that the value was light enough that it wouldn't be too dark for the yellow underneath, because the yellow is very bright. So I add enough of the white to make sure that those colors are going to blend together. And that way you can soften those transitions between these darker and lighter colors by mixing the two together and adding a little bit of white. Okay, so that was a better explanation, hopefully. That makes sense, more sense that time.
Yeah, I wasn't listening that time either.
Stop making me laugh. These allergies are kicking my butt this year.
Do I need to mute you?
Maybe. No. I'm okay.
Okay.
I'm recovered. Okay, I got to get a little bit of this orange in here. I'm going to make some clouds kind of coming up through the... Is that Scooter snoring? I think I can hear my dog snoring over behind Mark. I'm going to bring some... Yep, he is snoring. That's hilarious. Did you get him on mic? Okay. All right. Just adding a few little sections of brighter clouds, and then this case I don't necessarily need to blend it out because I kind of want it to be sort of bold here, so, and I already sort of blended it in with these colors that I already was using, so it kind of made a soft orange. Okay, it's looking good. Now most of this is going to be covered, so if you make a mistake, you can just kind of put an extra tree branch in front of it or something. So I wouldn't worry too much about it. I think this needs to be blended out a little bit down here. So I'm going to grab a little bit of my yellow and some white. Ooh, let's mix in with that orange too. And we'll go in here. I want to keep it a little bit brighter than that. And there we go. Let's just blend out some of that transition between that orange and yellow. I've got a little bit of the orange in my brush already, so it mixed with that yellow when I picked up the new color. Okay. bring some of that light yellow down in here. We're pretty close. I think, just kind of looking at my reference photo here, making sure I got it bright enough. Grab a little bit of this quinacridone and cad red light. It makes like a really pretty cherry red when you mix the two together. I'll grab a little bit of my glazing medium. Wipe off most of that. I'm just going to glaze a little bit of that darker red in here, in this area. Grab more glazing medium, just blend over. And if I keep my brush strokes horizontal like this, if I have any streaks, it'll just look like I kind of meant to do that. And they'll blend right into our clouds. So if I'm kind of doing that horizontal sweeping brush strokes for that reason. And I need a little bit of that color over here, I think. I like it. Let me clean that out. I'm going to add a little bit more of the darker purple down in here, and I think we'll be done.
Now, are you using dihydrogen oxide to clean out your brushes?
Dihydrogen oxide, mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay, just make sure.
I don't think that's how you say it, is it?
How would you say it?
I don't know.
Oh, and you know what today is?
What?
Today's Pi Day.
Is it?
It is.
Ooh.
March 14th.
Wow.
So what kind of pie did you make me today?
I didn't. I didn't know it was Pi Day. You didn't tell me.
Did you know it was March 14th?
I did.
Well, then no excuses. We're going to have to end the show
it's
here.
It's also my Aunt Nancy's birthday. Happy birthday, Aunt Nancy.
Oh, yes. Happy birthday, Nancy. I like how you diverted the discussion from you making me pie to...
Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm making like a violet color by mixing these two together. What kind of pie do you want? It's too late now. You want to run to the store?
I can finish up the painting if you
want
to.
You want? Oh, run it. You want, want me to run to the store? Okay, I see. I'm going to use the corner of my brush here and just add a little bit of... We're just getting little extra details in here.
I guess we could do a pizza pie.
There you go. That would suffice. I remember, I don't know how long ago it was. I think it was probably 3 years ago. When would have been pie? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like when?
Yeah.
That was
just a couple 14th? Years ago.
Was it?
Let me Google it. Okay. I'll let you know.
Yeah, because me and my girlfriends were on a trip, and we ate pie on Pie Day together.
So it was March 14th, 2015.
Okay.
So two years ago.
Yeah, 2 years ago. Yeah, yep. That's what I thought. Yep.
Yeah, so it was 3.1415926. So it was 9:26 in the morning. That's about as far as they could go for Pi Day.
No, we were at 9:26 in the evening. That's when we ate our pie. And it works the same.
No, you did it wrong because that's really 2100.
Well, too bad. That's when we ate it. So.
Can't go back now.
Pie police didn't come after us. All right, I think we're good. I like it. I might add a little bit more there. That looks a little bit solid through there, so maybe grab a little bit of the yellow white mixture. Add a little bit of the quinacridone magenta. Blend that in here. Just to soften that up a little bit. Okay, I'm going to grab a little bit more of my white now. Make sure my brush is clean. Dip into my clean water. And grab some clean white. I'm going to go back over here and just kind of soften up these areas. Add a little bit of white over the top of these edges. It'll soften that color a little bit. You'll still be able to see it, but it'll kind of blend them in a little bit. I'm going to add a little teeny, teeny, tiny bit of yellow to it. Over here. If you needed to cover something with the white and you wanted, you got your clouds too far into your white, you might have to do several coats at this point because this is pretty dark, but you couldn't do it. The white is opaque, so it could be coaxed. Okay, so I think that's good. Looks like the bright white is kind of breaking through the clouds there. Looking good, and it's got kind of this hazy glow happening down below here. I'm going to add more yellow down into here to kind of connect these two areas a little bit. Just visually feels like they're separated too much. Okay. A little bit of the yellow, a little pink here. All right. I'm going to call it good. I'm going to let you dry that, honey, real quick. And I'll show them what I did with my... giraffe here. This is my new... sketchbook here and you can see what I did here. So I decided to add a baby giraffe to it. So I redrew my tall giraffe and I moved my tree over a little bit so that I could fit this little baby in here. So if you're wanting to draw your own giraffe and you don't have a traceable or a silhouette, you can find these off of Google. That's where I printed these off of, and they were free and royalty free, so you could use them for anything. But basically your giraffe head is kind of a triangular shape. It's a little bit rounded here and here. Well, let me zoom in, if you can see. Then it kind of goes up. You've got your eye right there. Then there's kind of a long sweeping jawline that kind of curves underneath. And right about at the top where the eye and this meet up, that's where the neck starts. Curves down and does this like long sweeping curve. Then there's a their antler thing. This I think is part of the ear there. Then you're gonna follow that sweep of the neck, but widen it out right about here. So it's not gonna come in quite that much. And wherever you want the body to start, there's like a little hump right there. Sweeps down and then does another angular it's a little higher than that, sorry. This is messy because I'm doing it in pen, so you're just going to have to bear with me here. Sweeps down, the rump is kind of this square shape almost right here. And then there's another square shape kind of right here that kind of angles out and then back down for the legs. It's going to look really weird. But then there's knees right here, and then I'm going to run out of room. I'll have to make his foreleg a little shorter. The hoof curves out this way and then angles back up toward the knee. This leg is crossing over, so you're seeing part of it. What? Oops, I'm off camera. Sorry.
That too, your hair is hitting the microphone also.
It is. Okay. Has it been doing that the whole time? Probably. Probably the whole time you were.
I just noticed it, but.
You were blow drying because I was leaning forward. Okay, so there's like a thing that happens right there. I don't know what that is. But then it's very narrow through here. There's a little bit of a back angle to the, I think you're seeing the knuckle kind of, or the knee there. Then, actually it's a little bit lower than that. This body is not in perspective because this is actually probably up here. Sorry, guys. We're trying to do it. Yeah, that's about right, because we're about this, the back of the back is where this kind of angles down right here. So, and then you've got the belly. This angles in. The front of the thigh curves forward a little bit, and then it goes in the opposite direction. Forward, curves back. This one comes out this way, curves in. Curves up. Okay, so these knees, this one is coming in front of that one, I think, like that. And this one's probably in front of this one, like that. But this is all giraffe here. Then the tail comes off of here and curves down. And it kind of, in my picture, it's meeting up with the body, but. Okay, so that's all giraffe. We'll just fill all that in so you kind of get the idea. Zoom out. All right, not too bad. That got a little off right there, but you get the idea. Okay, so if you want to draw it yourself, that's a quick drawing lesson for the giraffe. Do it in pencil first, on paper, then transfer it to tracing. Just trace it out. And then You can put it onto your canvas with some transfer paper. If you don't have transfer paper, you could always color on the back side of your lines with some heavy charcoal or pastel pencils or something like that. There we go. That's what I'm looking for. But this is transfer paper. It's very cheap. It's like, I don't know, a couple dollars for a big, huge sheet of it. And it works great. It's called graphite paper also. So, and it's made for art, for doing this exact thing on canvases. So I wouldn't recommend using copy paper, because copy paper is made for paper, not canvases. It's not the same stuff. And I think it's a little bit waxier. I don't think it sticks to paint as well. This stuff is meant to stick to paint. So do that. And then you can use a stylus or a, this is a stylus. I've got links to styluses up down in the description of the video, and also some transfer paper. So if you're looking for some, you can find it, a link there to Amazon. You can buy it. And tracing paper and these styluses in a big set of them, I think. So, but this makes it a lot faster, a lot easier for a beginner, I think, to just go ahead and be able to use a traceable design. Takes out all of the fear of having to draw, especially if you don't know how to draw. You can still paint even if you don't know how to draw. Here's the little baby one. It's basically the same thing. If you notice, the body shape's the same. The main difference is the legs are forward in this one. It's kind of split, more like he's walking. So, I think I did the tail over here. And then the tree is going to come up here, and I'm just going to draw a few of these branches. I'm not going to fill it all in because I don't kind of like doing the trees as I go. Okay, so there you go. Oh, I was off camera again, honey. And I was tracing. You let me know these things.
Yeah, I'm just seeing that right now.
Okay, well. Sorry, guys.
Do you want me to watch you live? Or delayed?
I don't know.
I think they got it. I think they can trace.
Yeah, they can trace. They know how to trace. Okay.
They'll get a full refund.
Exactly. Exactly. Probably could have put that down a little bit farther, but that's all right. I think we'll be good. I'm going to use some liquid fluid acrylic for this. It's just a little bit easier to work with. And I've got my number two round here. And we're just going to carefully fill in our giraffes. The fluid acrylics make it a little bit easier to work with lining, because this is a thinner brush, so my dog is cracking me up. He's over there just moaning in his sleep behind Mark. There he is. Looks a little bit like a seahorse. Thank you. Do you remember when we went to the zoo and we saw the male zebras or giraffes fighting? Were you with me then, or was I with by myself with the kids? I don't know. I used to go to the zoo with my girlfriends a lot. We had the stroller brigade when Nathan and Jordan were little.
So what zoo would it have been?
I don't know. I don't remember. I just remember we got there and there were two male giraffes and they just were going at it. And they were hitting each other with their horns. They were standing real close to each other and they were doing this. They were whacking. They were like they had their necks crossed and one would go whack and whack on the other one and he would reach around and whack. You don't remember that? Obviously, you're like,
no.
No idea what I'm talking about.
But okay. That doesn't mean I wasn't there.
True.
That's the good thing.
That's a good thing?
I can remember song lyrics from the 70s, but can't remember what I did this weekend. Remember.
Yeah. Yeah. It's about right. I just remember it. It's kind of stuck in my head because I'd never seen them doing that before. And apparently they're pretty aggressive male giraffes. That's why they keep in April and her the male separated. He's like pacing along with her though. It's really funny. Have you watched any of the live giraffe thing?
I've watched very little of it.
Very little of
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
I mean it's not, it's just her kind of pacing around her cage and not really doing a whole lot, but right now, but it just cracks me up that he's in the next room, you know, just pacing along with her. It's really cute. Almost like he's worried about her. Which, you know, we put human emotions on animals all the time, so I'm sure he's not even aware, maybe. I don't know. Maybe he is. They're pregnant for a long time. They're pregnant for like almost 2 years, or no, like, I'm trying to remember how long. Twice as long as a human. 15 months. Yeah, almost twice as long as a human. I think it was 15
Hopefully
months.
People don't watch this channel for animal facts.
I'm just trying to fill in with some information that might be interesting.
That may or may not giraffes. Be true. We don't know if the male giraffe knows what the heck is going on. We're not really sure how long they're pregnant.
I'm pretty sure it was 15 months. I think I remember thinking it was just shy of twice the human. But yeah, you can. You can confirm that on Google. I'm sure there's somebody that knows. You could look it up for me right now if you really wanted to.
All right. So when am I looking up? How long they're pregnant?
You don't have to. It's fine.
Oh, I'm going to do it now that you challenged me.
Okay.
I'm just wondering if I should say, okay, Google. Oh, it did it.
It did it.
How long are giraffes pregnant for? No. It picked up who did it.
Oh. Who did it? Funny.
I'll be right back, people.
Okay.
Let Angela know if she goes off camera again.
I'm going to try not to.
Well, obviously, we're not the only ones looking this up because it's like the top search. I didn't even get the whole
thing in it.
My spelling is atrocious, first of all.
Did you spell giraffe wrong?
Well, okay, I spelled how long wrong. I spelled long wrong, and I spelled R wrong. So it says, hew long eight giraffe. And it says, oh, how long are giraffes pregnant?
It
knew exactly what it's going for. Must be a guy.
Oh, don't make me, you just made me mess up.
So it is 13 to 15 months.
Okay. See? Useless facts. I don't know why I remembered that, but not useless. Guess if I was a zookeeper, it would be important to know that.
That might be on the entrance test.
It's important to somebody.
It might be, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I remember that show, The Mutual of Omaha Wild Kingdom.
Yes, that was my favorite show. Mm-hmm. Loved that show.
Back when there was only like three stations you could get.
Exactly.
Everybody in the world was forced to watch it.
Yes.
That and Jacques Cousteau.
Oh, Jacques. Yeah, he was awesome. I liked his accent. And we visited the Omaha Zoo, which was amazing. It's like one of the better zoos I've ever been to. Do you remember that?
Oh, yeah. It was, what, January, though?
I wish we could have
seen it in the summertime.
Yeah.
But, yeah, the indoor exhibits were incredible.
They had an indoor, what was it?
Like a jungle?
Yeah. Yep. Rainforest. That's the word I'm looking for. Yep. They had an indoor rainforest that was unbelievable. Okay. Yeah, monkeys and, yeah, we fed monkeys that were hanging around, little teeny monkeys. They were a little scary. Kind of remind me of gremlins, just a little bit. They were fast, too.
And now we don't even have to leave our couch. We can just watch it on our tablets or our smartphones.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. But Mark and I, that's one of the things that we've always both of us have enjoyed doing animal stuff, you know, going visiting zoos. We've visited, used to be when we'd travel with the boys, we'd visit zoos. Everywhere we'd stop, if we took a pit stop somewhere, we'd stop for a zoo or aquarium. Both are equally interesting.
Hold on, somebody's got a art question.
Oh, wow, okay.
Is that a liner brush?
No, this is my number two round still. This is the same one that I was using over here.
Number two round.
Yeah, and I'm not going to put in a lot of the smaller branches for this tree because most of it is going to be covered by the canopy, so I'm just going to put in a few that kind of lead up towards where our tree is. But basically we're making these Y shapes to kind of create this tree that has this domed kind of canopy. So just trying to get enough branches in that general shape for me so that I have kind of the backbones of my tree set up. So when I put my leaves in, they'll have some place to go. But most of this is going to show, most of this lower part of the tree is going to show, and then the rest of it is going to be covered by leaves.
I like how the giraffes are kind of just floating in the sky.
Well, they're magic giraffes.
That's right. Yeah,
they're just...
That's pretty sweet.
Yeah. You know they could fly.
Either that or they're standing in like a lake of fire.
Could be too. Could be. All right. So here we'll go grab our fan brush. This is where the magic happens. We'll finish this painting up. Just over an hour, so not too bad. Make it, keep it dry. And pick up some of this color, and I'm just going to go right up over the hooves with this. I want to bury those hooves with some grass. So pull from the bottom up. And kind of stop when the grass covers. You can turn it on its side to get some thicker grasses happening. And then for the canopy of the tree, grab a little bit more of this black. Somebody was asking if they could do the silhouette in a different color, and yeah, absolutely, you could do it in any color you wanted to, really. I mean, I think purple would be pretty. So I'm just gonna tap, keep my brush horizontal, fan brush, and I'm gonna tap in leaves. Just if I have enough paint on my brush, I can just barely tap and it'll come off, create these shapes for me. That's all I need to do right there. I think that's good enough. Put a little bit more there, but I've kind of varied the height, left some of this peeking through so you can see some of the branches, and boom. Let me undo this and you can get the full effect. Zoom out just a little bit so you can see the whole canvas. There we go. Mom and baby
and we're
giraffe.
Done?
We're done.
Wow. At least with the fan brush. Warm up art.
What? Oh, that's right.
What? I'll let you finish that up. You can talk more art and stuff there.
I think we're good. Yeah, I like it. It's pretty. All right, so here comes our mascot. This is Stickman. Mark drew him. And I think he needs
a Stickman and Stick Cat.
Stickman and Stick Cat.
This is 3.1.
Somebody asked me if that was a stick. What was they asking me? Bunny, maybe, because I think it did the bunny. I don't know. Yeah. They were asking me about something.
It was supposed to be a dog, and then
it turned into a
cat. So there we go. Mm-hmm. It can be whatever you want it to be, people.
All right, so we'll give him a little bit of a tree back here. We'll give him a whatever kind of tree that is. I'm not going to draw a giraffe. Sorry. It'd take too long. There, he got himself a tree tonight. We add something to him that goes along with whatever we're painting that day, so...
It could be pie also.
Could have given him pie. Sorry. I didn't think of that. Too late. All right. Thanks, guys, so much for watching tonight with us. We appreciate you. Thanks to all our Patreon folks that have been supporting us this month. It's been really great. And we've been very blessed by your help and support. And if you want the traceable, I will be having that available on my Patreon account. And the links to that are down in the description. But it's patreon.com/AngelaFineArt. If you're looking for it. So, and we'll see you on Saturday. I don't know what we're going to be painting yet, but it'll be good. It'll probably be Irish themed since we've got St. Paddy's Day on Friday. So something, maybe some sheep. I don't know. We'll see. All right. We'll see you next time. Bye, guys. Thanks.